Hey winners, Kevin Ward here again. Okay, we're talking about the for sale by owner over the phone who says, what commission do you charge? How much do you charge in your commission? Will you reduce your commission? Will you cut your commission? I'm looking for a discount broker, whatever it is. Now, you've already probably watched the video on the for sale by owner phone objections, part one on will you cut your commission. You need to watch that one first. Now, this one, because that's going to deal with 90% of the over the phone objections that you have on commission. But there's the one, there's always the one, the for sale by owner who insists, if you don't give me a number, we're not meeting. And they're just like adamant. And I call that the FSBO frick. All of this is the FSBO frick. It's the friction that for sale by owners give you over your commission. And you just have to learn that, you know what? That's why they're doing it. It's the economics. They just don't want to waste their money, and they don't see the value in what you deliver. So your job is to be able to demonstrate the value is there, that you can actually help them net as much or more money in their pocket and do it in a way that is in their best interest. That's what's important to a for sale by owner. Look, for sale by owners are not against realtors. What they're against is wasting their money. Okay, and so many agents don't know how to deliver that value. So that's what you've got to do. And let's go back to this objection here. And I got this. This was because of an email from one of my clients that says, you know, I ran into this and they wanted to know what the commission was. And I tried using another trainer's objection handler and it didn't work. Well, go figure. So here's what I'm going to tell you. Quit dodging their questions over the phone. Now, here's the thing, and this is what's really important. I think I mentioned this in the other video, is there is a difference between deferring to an objection versus dodging a question. I can defer the question and say, you know what, that's a great question. That's obviously something we'll talk about when we meet. I'm not dodging the question. I'm saying I'm deferring it until we meet. And then you're going to absolutely be able to deal with it then. That's the time to deal with it. But if they insist, they say, well, how much commission do you charge? Well, like I said, we're not going to talk about it over the phone. Well, I just want to know your number. Well, if I sell it, and then we get start stumbling around, because what we're trying to do is dodge the question. Don't dodge the question. Look, here's the thing with a for sale by owner. There is almost automatically a trust gap. Here's the for sale by owner. Here's you. They are skeptical that you can do anything for them that's worth the money. That's a trust gap. That's a credibility gap. How do you bridge that gap? Well, you've got to connect with them and show them that you care about helping them get the result they want and not just a commission. And you've got to help them to see that there is value in what you deliver. And if you start dodging their question, what happens whenever you ask somebody a simple question and they won't answer it? The trust gap, does it get smaller or bigger? It obviously gets bigger. So you're now pushing them away by dodging their question. So you don't have to do that, okay? And somebody says, well, don't ever give the commission over the phone, because if you do, you're screwed, okay? Well, that is because most people that teach that don't understand negotiating. They don't understand how you get a yes. And here's the answer. When you give an answer, okay, if you give the commission, do you weaken your position for the future? In a way, yes, you do. So what's the pullback? The pullback is you've got to be in control of the conversation, and you've got to be demonstrating that. And there's that confidence, the confidence factor that comes through in that, the C factor that comes through in your confidence when you're talking to them. So when they ask you a question, okay, they're in control. Because who's in control of the conversation? It's always the one who is asking the question. Now, stay with me, because this is critical that you understand this dynamic if you want to be effective and powerful with people like for sale by owners, expireds, and so forth. So number one, you got to understand the one asking the questions is in control. So if they ask you a question and you just answer the question, who's in control? They're still in control. So the key is that when they ask you a question, you address the question. Whether you're answering it or deferring it is fine. But you've got to then follow it with another question, which puts you back into control. Now, this is not a manipulation, a contest here. It's simply that you know the direction you want this conversation to go, and that is to an appointment. So you've got to be the one in control. Means you've simply got to be the one leading the conversation. This isn't mind games or trying to manipulate or con people. Okay, you are legitimately trying to help a for sale by owner do something that is in their best interest, that will help them get a better result than if they try to do it themselves. Because think about it. We're dealing with a $200,000, half million, $2 million asset, and they're wanting to do it yourself. Okay. Now, doing it yourself when you're, you know, installing, excuse me, when you're installing a toilet paper holder in your bathroom, that's one thing. But when you're trying to sell a $750,000 asset, having a professional probably is a pretty good idea. You got to determine, you got to demonstrate that value. So the question is, so I want to know exactly tell me what commission you charge. Well, it's a fair question. I charge the standard 6%. However, whenever you meet with me, you're going to see you're not going to get standard service. You're going to get way beyond standard service. Fair enough? Now, that's one way you can do it. Another way you can do it, and there's a whole lot of ways you can do this depending on how it's coming out and how the question comes out. But if they say, so what commission do you charge? Great question. Well, I'm a full service broker. First of all, you got to understand, I'm a full service broker. So if you're looking for the cheapest guy, it's probably not me. Now, my charge is simply the ordinary 6%. However, my service and results are way beyond ordinary. And when we meet, I'm going to be able to share with you exactly what I mean by that. Fair enough? Okay, that's one other approach that you can take. Another one is pretty much the same, and you can just say, you know, it's a fair question. I charge a standard 6% commission because I'm a full-service broker. Do you have any other agents telling you anything different? Now, what did I just do? In all three of those cases, I answered the question, and then I ask a question back. And that last one, if you know that you're competing with other agents who they've told you are going to discount their commission, to say, are you having other agents telling you anything different? Because here's what happens. You'll be amazed how many for sale by owners will say, well, no, but I've just been told that agents will discount their commissions. Aha. Okay, that's a very different answer than they say, oh, yeah, I've got 7 or 8 agents telling me they'll do it for 4%. Really? Okay. So have you already met with some of these agents? You know, if they tell, I got one, and then I always ask, what's the cheapest they've told you? Well, one said they'd do it for 3.5%. 3.5%. Interesting. Now, I'm not antagonistic. This is not adversarial. It's interesting. So have you already met with that agent? Okay. No, they just told me that over the phone. So they told you over the phone they'd do it for 3.5%. Interesting. Well, listen, I'm going to make a note of that. And when we meet again, commissions are negotiable and we'll make sure we arrive at a commission that both of us feel comfortable about. Fair enough? Great. So when will be the best time for us to get together? I can come out tomorrow afternoon at 2:15, or would around 6:15 in the evening be better for you guys? Awesome. Well, look, I will look forward to seeing you and your wife tomorrow at 2:15, and we got some great stuff to talk about. Now, it's that simple. I'm straightforward, I'm honest, but look at my face. Look at my tonality. Look at my body language. Look at the way I say it. I am confident. And you need to say that right now. Say, I am confident. I can help that for sale by owner. I'm not going to make a contest of it or an argument over the commission on the phone. I'm simply going to acknowledge it. I know where they're coming from. This is not a surprise. They know I want to charge more than they want to pay. Okay, we're just establishing the starting point so that when we meet, we know. That's all they're wanting to do. So all I'm doing is a great question. I'm answering it perfect. When we meet, we'll talk about it. We'll make sure we get something that's a win-win for both of us. Obviously, is the most important thing to you, is it the cheapest commission or is it getting the most money in your pocket and actually getting your home sold? See, focus back on the results that they want, not the process. The commission is not the issue to them. It's the result, and that is the money in their pocket. So stay clear and help them stay clear on what really is important. And every time you talk to them, engage the opportunity, play to win, and always expect a yes, and you'll get it.